Okay, let's have a look at adding cabinets to this tiny house. And so what I want to do for this living room, because we have a little bit more space, I want to push this bench seat over to the side, and I want to add more cabinetry to this space by adding a corner cabinet return here that will act as a little kitchen island, if that makes sense. All right, so what we're gonna do, we're just going to start by moving these bench seats around here. So I'm gonna click on this bench seat here and move it over to the corner. And you probably already guessed, I'm going to use the dimension move tool to bring this gap down here to zero. And what you will see, we've actually broken this up into three different bench seats, and I'll bring this bench seat over there to fit as well. And I'm going to go and remove this bench seat because I don't want to actually have a corner here anymore, but I only want to have one long bench seat. And so what you can do with cabinets, you can actually change the dimensions of them as well. So I want to get rid of the broken up part here and make this one long bench seat. So at the moment it is 1.6 meters wide or 1600 millimeters. And we will want to make this 2400 millimeters to fit the entire gap. So I'm just gonna click on here and make this 2.4 meters wide. And oops, I did something wrong. It shouldn't be 2.4 meters, it should be 2.2 meters. There we go. And I'll bring this down here to allow for the full width. And what I was saying in the previous section of the course, you actually have the predicament that sometimes the interior doesn't fit up with the exterior. So we'll see that we need to make this even smaller here, or this door even smaller, to make sure that it fits into the space. So I'll make this 1.6 meters, let's say. And now we'll bring this over here a little bit to get some better spacing. And now the panels don't make sense really anymore because they're much too slim. So we'll change the panel count to only two as well to make sure that this just looks somewhat right. Okay, cool. So now we've changed the interior layout of this bench seat. And now we will want to add some more cabinets and a corner return to create a bit of a kitchen island. So to do that, I'm going to click on my furniture menu. And just to give you an overview of all of the different items that are available, we have created six different categories of interior items. And to start with, we've got kitchen cabinets, which is super important when you're designing a tiny house, because most of the interior items will be cabinets and only a little bit of furniture. And then we have dining items like chairs and tables, and living room items like seating and other more comfortable chairs and coffee tables, and even some rugs here that you can use to make it a little bit more comfortable. And then we have bathroom items like the bathroom cabinets that I was showing you over here before. I'll go into that in a second. As well as bathroom objects like showers and toilets and more, like rain heads and shower rails. And then we've got bedroom items that are mainly just beds, and storage items that are preset cabinets that make sense as a storage solution. So I'm going to go back into my kitchen cabinet because that's what we want to add here, and it's a kitchen cabinet. So we'll go into my kitchen and we'll just want to add a smaller, let's say a triple drawer cabinet here, and then a corner return here. So let's say we want to grab a ground cabinet and we'll want to have a triple drawer like this. There we go. And what you'll see, it's facing the wrong way at the moment. And then I'll just, so to change it around, I'll just left click on the arrows here to rotate it by 180 degrees. So I clicked it twice. Then I'll change the width here to, let's say, 300 millimeters. And we'll bring it over to the left again to make no gap in between here. And then I'll scroll down until I find my right corner cabinet, my left corner cabinet. And then I will rotate it again just a little bit. I actually have to click it three times this time to bring this corner cabinet around. There we go. But in this case, we're actually seeing that this cabinet doesn't fit. So we'll actually just get rid of it and just add a couple more cabinets here. Let's say we'll just add another open shelf cabinet like this, like a triple open shelf like this. There we go. And now we can finish up the design of our kitchen. Just as a quick reminder, what you'll see here when you're clicking on the cabinets, you can actually change the height from the ground. So let's say if you want to elevate your cabinet, you can type in how far away from the ground it should be. So that's how you would create overhead cupboards. So you can see that there's a height from ground setting here as well. That was put to 1430 in this case. But you can also just create your own cabinets this way. What you also see here is a bit of a reminder. We actually have more settings for cabinets to the point where you can change the exact layout of each cabinet. So you can even change how many segments you want to have, how thick your countertop should be. Do you want to have double doors or triple doors or whatever you can imagine, you can add that into your cabinets. And that's part of the business version. So if you're a builder, you will have more options here to add some more specific cabinets for your clients. Okay, so that's how you would change your cabinets. And I'm just going to do this one more time just with the example of the bathroom here. And I'll just disable my lofts here like this. And I'm actually quite happy with the arrangement of this kitchen, or not kitchen, bathroom vanity, but I'm not quite happy with the size of my shower here. So I'm just going to go and change the size of my shower to fit in fully here. Actually, let's add a storage cabinet in here instead. Maybe we can put in some towels or something like that. So we'll go into my storage cabinets here and we'll add a bookshelf preset. And of course this has some nice open shelves here that we can put towels into, and we'll just make it much deeper to, let's say, 800 millimeters. Or how deep is the shower? It's 900 millimeters. So we'll make this it's 800 millimeters deep, and we'll make it 500 millimeters wide like that and push it to the left like this. And now we have a nice storage shelf for my towels and other toiletries that we might want to add in here. All right, so that's how you would define your cabinets.